I'm here at Nottingham University to look at this really quite revolutionary hydrogen refueler and drive this revolutionary hydrogen car by Hyundai. It's a marriage of these two really significant things. You'll be able to lease this car soon. Ordinary people can lease a hydrogen SUV, and you will be able to come and fill up in hydrogen refuelers like this all over the country. That is the beatific vision. That's why I'm here, and it's not that far away.
Well, what we've got today is that ITM Power are starting their Eco Island project, and we're collaborating with them. The Eco Island project, ITM Power are looking to develop a hydrogen refueler which is four times the size of the Nottingham refueler, which you can see behind me. The refueler is a very exciting development because we're actually going to be taking green electricity that we're generating from PV panels on the roof of our new Energy Technologies building, and we're using that green electricity to generate hydrogen on site. And so we've got sustainable hydrogen that's producing no carbon emissions, and then we're going to use that hydrogen within vehicles. So we're going to have a small fleet of hydrogen vehicles on the university, and we can also use the hydrogen within our R&D labs, part of the Energy Technologies building, where we're looking to investigate things like smart grid communities.
Driving this hydrogen SUV, just completely conventional. Absolutely. You just put it into drive and push the throttle down and off she goes. She does it in complete silence, but it takes literally the same time to fill it as it does a petrol car, so there's no compromise there. You've got 300 odd miles range, so again the same as a petrol car, but it's smooth, it's fast, it's quick, and it's eerily quiet and exciting. So anybody who thinks this is a bad thing, that this is a change that we don't want, it really is the most exciting thing to happen to the car for maybe 100 years.
So the research that we've been doing on hydrogen is we've been looking at solid-state storage of hydrogen, because this is the most compact way of storing hydrogen. With the Hyundai vehicle that you can see behind me, then that uses 700 bar tank. So there's two issues. Number one, it's a very high pressure. Number two, it is a very large tank. You're probably looking at 250 litre tank. What we're wanting to do is investigate technologies that will reduce the size of that tank, so get it down towards about 100 litres in size. And the way that you can do that is actually storing the hydrogen, not as a gas, but as a solid. And so we're investigating a number of materials that act like a sponge, take the hydrogen from gas into the solid state, and it holds onto the hydrogen at lower pressures as well. So instead of having the tank to operate at 700 bar, our solid-state tanks might only operate at 10 bar.
Nottingham is a world leader in hydrogen technology, and that's great. And we need to push it. It's absolutely essential, because in these fiscally constrained times, it would be so easy for all this stuff to fall off the page. And then in 10 years, we're going to say, what a shame we didn't do that. So this is really, really important. And blokes like me have a moral obligation to come here and say, this is where it all is. World leading hydrogen research and development center. We need to give it all the energy, all the resources we can, so that our kids don't have to be chained to the fossil fuel monster. So we can develop the infrastructure, we can develop the cars, and we can have cheap, clean fuel. That's what it's all about. This is the future being cast here at Nottingham University.